Good morning, everyone. Now let us start the new chapter, that is the equilibrium. This is the lesson number 7 and this is the part 1. So let us discuss about actually what equilibrium is. So it is a common observation that most of the reaction when carried out in a closed vessels do not go to completion under given set of a temperature and the pressure, and in all such cases in the initial stage only the reactant are present, but as the reaction proceeds the concentration of the reactant decreases and that the product increases. For example, initial stage we have the two reactant A and B. So in the reaction state there is only the concentration of reactant is present, we don't have any product, but as the reaction goes on, as the time passes on, so we get the product. For example, we get the product AB. So as the time goes on or the reaction proceeds, the concentration of the reactant decreases. This is the reactant, so the concentration of the reactant decreases, whereas the concentration of the product AB is the product, the concentration of the product is increasing. Now finally a stage is reached when no further change in the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product. So after some time what happened, we reaches a stage then at that stage there is no change in the concentration of the reactant, these are the reactant, as well as there is no change in the concentration of the product, this one is the product. So at this state there is a balance. When there is no change in the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product, so there is a balance between the reactant and the product, and the reaction appears to be stopped. If we have seen the reaction at that time, so it is observed that the reaction seems to be stopped because there is no change in LHS as well as no change in RHS takes place, and this state or stage is known as equilibrium. This is called equilibrium state. This state is called the equilibrium state, means no change in the concentration of the reactant as well as no change in the concentration of the product. Now before starting the chapter equilibrium, there are a few terms which are very very important. We have to, first of all, we have to discuss these terms. So the first term is equilibrium. This is the name of your lesson, equilibrium. So equilibrium is a state. Equilibrium is a state at which the concentration of the reactant, this is the reactant suppose, at which the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product do not change with time. Do not change with time. This state is known as the equilibrium. And in this state can be recognized by the consistency of certain measurable property, and these measurable properties are maybe pressure, maybe density, maybe color, maybe concentration, and the amount of the reactant left depends on the experimental conditions such as the concentration, temperature, pressure and the nature of the reaction. So by changing these conditions of the system, we can control the extent to which the reaction is proceed. Now there is one more term, that is reversibility. Reversibility. The term is reversibility. It is extracted from the term reversible. Reversible means, for example, we have a reaction N2 plus 3H2, we get 2NH3. So such kind of reaction are reversible reaction. The meaning of the reversible reaction is when N2 and 3H2 combine, they produce 2NH3, and when 2NH3 split, it give us 3H2 plus N2. So this is called the reversible reaction or reversibility. Now the one topic is depend on the reversible reaction. So let us discuss this reaction. In this reaction, both the forward and the backward reaction are still taking place. Now here I am using the arrow, and this arrow is known as the double-headed arrow. This arrow is the single-headed arrow. This is the single-headed arrow, and this arrow is the double-headed arrow. And now this reaction, when we use the arrow in the upward direction, this is known as the forward direction. This is forward direction, and this is backward direction. This is backward direction. This is the upper one is the forward direction, and this one is the backward direction. Now look at here, both the forward, this is the forward means N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. This is the forward. Backward means 2NH3 split and it gives 3H2 plus N2. This is the backward direction. So here both the forward and the backward reaction are still taking place. But the rate of the forward and the backward reaction become equal. After some time, what happened? The rate of the forward reaction becomes equal to the rate of the backward reaction. As a result, the concentration of the each species becomes constant, and the system is said to be in the dynamic equilibrium. For that, we use the term dynamic equilibrium. That term is known as the dynamic equilibrium, when the concentration of all the species becomes constant. So dynamic means moving. Dynamic, the meaning of the dynamic is moving, and at a microscopic level the system is in motion. Thus there is no apparent change at the equilibrium, yet both the forward and the backward reaction continue to take place. It means what happened here in the dynamic equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction is equals to the rate of backward reaction. This is the main topic of the dynamic equilibrium, means the rate of forward reaction is always equals to the rate of backward reaction. Now we have another reaction, that is H2O. It is in the liquid state and it is changes into H2O, which is in the vapor state. Now the double half, here I am also using the double headed arrow. So the double half arrow or the double headed arrow indicate the process in both the direction, forward direction as well as backward direction, are going on simultaneously. Means the H2O, which is in the liquid form, is converted into the vaporous form, and the H2O, which is in the vaporous form, is converted into the liquid form. So in both the direction the reactions takes place simultaneously, and the mixture of the reactant, this is the reactant and this one is the product. So the mixture of the reactant and the product in the equilibrium state. This is the equilibrium. This is the mark for the equilibrium. When we are denoting any equilibrium reaction, so we have to mention this mark. This is the important mark. This is the sign for the equilibrium. So the mixture of the reactant and the mixture of the product in the equilibrium state is known as the equilibrium. This is called the equilibrium mixture. This is called the equilibrium mixture. The concentration of reactant and the concentration of the product at the time of the equilibrium is known as the equilibrium mixture. So these are the terms. One is the equilibrium, this is the reversibility, this is the dynamic equilibrium, and third one is the equilibrium mixture. So let us continue with the dynamic equilibrium. So the stage of the system is dynamic equilibrium, when the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of the backward reaction, both are equal, and it is due to the dynamic equilibrium stage that there is no change in the concentration of the various species of the reaction mixture, and based on the extent to which the reaction proceed to reach the state of chemical equilibrium may be classified into the various group. So the first group is the reaction that proceed nearly to the completion and only negligible concentration of the reactant are left in some cases. This is the one of the possibility. The first possibility is maybe the reaction proceed to nearly completion. Now the reaction is going to be complete. This is the first possibility. The reaction is going to be complete. And if the reaction is going to be complete, means there is very negligible reactant is left. This is the one possibility. The second possibility is the reaction in which only a small amount of product are formed. There are so many reactions in which the only a small amount of products are formed and most of the reactant remain unchanged at the equilibrium state. There is no change. If the small amount of product is formed, it means the whole of the reactant is not utilized. And the third possibility is that the reaction in which there are so many reactions in which the concentration of the reactant and the product are comparable. When the system is in the equilibrium, so the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of product are comparable. So the extent of the reaction in equilibrium varies with the experimental conditions, such as if we change the concentration of the reactant or the temperature. These all are the different conditions. Now the next topic is equilibrium in physical process. Equilibrium in physical process. In this topic, we have to discuss the equilibrium, how the equilibrium is set in the physical process. Now, let's first of all clear the heading physical process. Actually, what are the physical process? So, physical process means, for example, melting of ice to water. The ice melts and it convert into the form of the water. It is the physical process. Evaporation of water to steam. The water is evaporated and it is converted into steam. It is also the physical process. Dissolution of sugar in water. If we dissolve some amount of sugar in the water, this is also the physical process. Now, there is another term, that is the chemical process. So, the chemical process means, for example, where the chemical reaction takes place. For example, if we want to discuss the equilibrium in the decomposition of the calcium carbonate, the calcium carbonate is decomposes into the calcium oxide and the carbon dioxide. So it is a chemical process. Next is the if we study the reaction between the hydrogen and the iodine. So these are the chemical process. But now our first topic is the equilibrium in the physical process. We know that the substance exists in the three states in nature, and these three states are: one is the solid, another one is the liquid, and the third one is the gas. So we have the three states of matter. So if we want to discuss the equilibria, so we have the three types of equilibrium that exist in between these three states of the matter. So the first equilibria is in between solid, this is the equilibrium, and liquid, this is the first type of equilibrium. The second is in between the, that is the second is the liquid, and there is the equilibrium mark. Liquid is converted into the gas, and the third one is the solid. Now the solid have the equilibrium with the gas. So in case of the state of matter, three state of matter, we have the three kind of the equilibria. Now let us discuss these type of the equilibrium one by one. So our first topic is solid liquid equilibrium. This is the first topic, solid liquid equilibrium. To specify the solid liquid equilibrium, we have certain exercises or we have certain experiment to define the solid liquid equilibrium. Let us discuss one example. For example, we have some ice. We have some ice and lots. We have few amount of a water in a perfectly insulated thermos flask. Now here we use the perfectly insulated thermos flask means in which the heat is not exchanged in between the outer weather or inside the container. And let us keep the thermos flask at the temperature of 273 Kelvin, and the pressure is normal atmospheric pressure. Since the flask is insulated, so there will be no exchange of heat in between its content and the surrounding. Surrounding means the area which is outside the thermos flask. So we notice that as long as the temperature remain constant, there is no change in the mass of ice and the water. There is no change in the mass and the ice of water. But if we could observe the individual molecule of the ice and the water, we would notice that considerably activity is still taking place and some molecule of liquid water are colliding against the ice and are adhering on the ice at the same time. Some molecule of ice go into the liquid. So these two process act in the opposite direction to each other. The two process means the first process is the some molecule of water adhere, they attach to the surface of the ice. And the second process means some molecule of the liquid are mix, sorry, the some molecule of the ice mixes with the molecule of the liquid. So these two process takes place continuously. But they both takes place in the opposite direction to each other. Since there is no change in the mass of the ice and the water, the number of the molecule going from water to ice, going from water to ice are as the same number of molecule going from ice to water. Now exactly what happened that H2O. H2O, it is present in the solid form, means it is the ice. We are talking about this example, solid liquid, and second is the H2O. This is liquid. It means that the number of the molecule of the H2O or water, which are in the solid form, and the number of molecule which converted into the liquid, and the number of molecule which converted from liquid to solid are same, means the LHS and the forward reaction and the backward reaction both are taking place simultaneously. They both the reaction take place simultaneously, or in other word, we can say that the rate of transfer of the molecule, the rate of transfer of the molecule from ice to water. And when we know very well, when the solid is converted into the liquid, it is a melting process, is same. The rate of transfer is same as the rate of the reverse transfer of the molecule of water to solid. It means it is a freezing process. So in the upper direction, the melting process takes place, and in the lower direction, the freezing process takes place. Therefore, the system shows a equilibrium consistency. It shows the equilibrium consistency. Why it shows? Because rate of melting, that is H2O, which is in the solid form, is converted into the H2O, which is in the liquid form, is equal to the rate of freezing. Freezing means, rate of freezing means the H2O which is in the liquid form is converted into the H2O which is in the solid form. So the both the reaction rate of melting and the rate of freezing are the equal. So the temperature at which the solid and the liquid phases are at equilibrium at atmospheric pressure is known as the normal freezing point or the melting of the substance. So this is the solid liquid equilibrium. This is all about the solid liquid equilibrium. Now the next topic is the liquid gas equilibrium, and it is also called the liquid vapor equilibrium. So this is if we want to understand this topic, so let us take a example. For that we consider that example of a transparent box. We have a transparent box. Suppose here, let us understood by this as a, we have a transparent box carrying a U-tube with mercury manometer, and it contain a U-shaped tube. This is the transparent container, and we have a U-shaped tube, and this tube is filled with the mercury. This is a manometer. A drying agent like anhydrous calcium chloride is placed for the few hours in the box. We have a petri dish or the china dish in which we have kept the calcium chloride. Here the CaCl2 act as a drying agent to absorb the moisture is placed in this box for few hours. After removing the drying agent by tilting the box on the one side, a watch glass containing water is quickly placed inside the box. Now after some time, what happened? We have to remove this calcium chloride. Actually the calcium chloride is placed here to remove all the humidity. So when we remove the calcium chloride from here, we have taken a china dish, that is a petri dish. This is the manometer. This is the U-shaped tube. It is filled with the mercury. And we here we place a petri dish, is a glass watch. It is a glass watch. It is a small container made with a glass. And we kept a petri dish which contained water, and we kept it inside this box. It will be observed that mercury level in the right limb of the manometer. This is the manometer. The mercury, it is observed when we place the water inside this container. So it is observed that mercury level in the right limb of the manometer slowly increases and finally attain the constant value. So let us, for example, this is a manometer. So it is when we place the water inside the box. So it is observed that the mercury level which is present in this manometer, it rises up. For example, at the initial state, the mercury is only up to this level. Then after some time, it is observed that the level of the mercury increases from this direction to this direction. The level of the mercury increases, and finally it attains a certain position, or it attained a definite position, or it reaches a definite value. And also the volume of the water in the watch glass decreases. And when we observe the watch glass, then it is observed that the water which is present, the volume of the water which is present inside the container, it decreases. As the water evaporated, the pressure in the box increases. Now it is observed that as the water evaporated from this box, so the pressure inside the box is increased due to the addition of water molecule to the gaseous phase. Because at the starting point, this box is empty. Nothing is present in this box. But as the water evaporated, the molecule of the water mixes with the molecules of the air which is present inside this box. The rate of the evaporation is constant. The rate of evaporation is constant means the rate of evaporation takes place with the time. There is no very large increment or there is no decrease in the concentration, but it goes with the time. So the rate of the increase in the pressure decreases with time due to the condensation of the vapor into the water. Finally, it leads to the equilibrium condition when there is no net evaporation takes place. Now, when the process of evaporation takes place, after it is observed that there is no evaporation takes place from the water or the china dish, so it implies that the number of the water molecule from the gaseous state into the liquid state also increases till the equilibrium is attained. Now, for that, the reaction is rate of evaporation is equal to rate of condensation. Rate of evaporation is equal to rate of condensation. The rate of evaporation means the molecule of the water evaporate from the china dish to the gaseous state, and the rate of condensation means the vapors which are present, the water vapor which are present here, they are condensed and we get it in the form of the water.